We got some insight today on the campaign from CBS News political director and Face the Nation moderator John Dickerson. He talked with our Melissa Caen about Mr. Trump's suggestion that gun rights supporters could stop Hillary Clinton.
Although the Second Amendment people, maybe there is, I don't know.
Part of it is the Clinton campaign jumped on this immediately. They're turning it into to an issue. So it's very murky. And what he said was open to interpretation. This is coming after a series of missteps on his part. So it kind of plays already into the view that a lot of people have that he's just kind of a volatile candidate.
Does he have an obligation to say things that can't be misconstrued in this way?
Well, it's part of his genius, and part of what people like about him is that he speaks his mind, and then he speaks in a kind of rough and not very politically polished way. On the other hand, when you're talking about, when you're brushing up against the idea that people might take up action to stop a sitting president or stop Supreme Court justices from doing something, you need to be careful when you have that kind of megaphone.
From a journalism perspective, how do you cover a candidate or candidates, frankly, when there's so much confirmation bias? There's right. So much disregard for facts.
I think the challenge is, and both candidates have challenges with the truth, but they have different kinds of challenges. Donald Trump has been at odds with the facts more times than any other major candidate we've had. The fact checkers have said that across different fact checking organizations. And then Hillary Clinton has her own case, which is that she says that things that didn't turn out to be true about her email server or what she said about trade is not quite the straight story. And those are things that she's talking about when she had actually the job of being Secretary of State.
Do you think that Hillary Clinton is lucky? Like, do you think that she is sort of secretly thrilled that she's running against Donald Trump as opposed to a different Republican candidate?
Certainly you would, when you talk to people involved in her campaign and when you talk to Democratic strategists, they say, given the difficult hand that she has to play, and that is that people don't think she's trustworthy, her unfavorable numbers are high, she's been in the public eye for a long time, which makes her a difficult candidate in an election where people are seeking change. So all of those liabilities make her lucky in the opponent she got with Donald Trump. And there are a lot of Democrats, and as I say, people in her campaign who will say that. They might not say it out loud, but they will say that, and Republicans say it a lot.
If you had to pick a moment so far in this election that you think either is pivotal or will be regarded as pivotal, what would you say up to now?
The back and forth that Donald Trump got into with the Caen family, mm-hmm. Captain Caen's parents, who spoke at the Democratic convention, that might be a turning point, because this question of temperament has always been the one the Trump campaign has said would be crucial. If people think he has the temperament to handle the job, the Trump advisors will say, then he'll win, because it's a change election and people just have to feel secure that they can hand him the presidency. Well, the fight with the Caen family got to this question of temperament, and so it reanimated a problem that was there already, but put a special focus on it.
John Dickerson stopping by our studio a little earlier this afternoon. He is in the Bay Area promoting his new book. It's called Whistle Stop, and in it he shares his favorite stories from presidential campaigns history.